Hey, good morning. Chuck here with Apple Drains. Today we're doing another video consultation, this time with a man that's on the coast of North Carolina. He's got a downspout and yard drain problem. Not really sure where he wants to send this water, so we're going to go meet Steve in New Bern, North Carolina.
Hello.
Hi, Steven.
Yes, this is Steve.
Hey, this is Chuck. Can you turn on your camera?
Yeah, let me figure out how to do that real quick, Chuck.
Okay.
There we go.
Yep, it's coming on. Hey, how you doing?
Hey, how are you?
Good, you look as tired as me.
yeah, it's been a long week. A very long week.
So, I got your diagram, and everything looks good. What exactly do you want to do out there?
What I'd like to do, I'm going outside now,
yep.
But what I really like to do is I need to get rid of the standing water.
Okay.
I had the landscapers come out. Actually, the turf farm guys, they came out and they had to look at the grass because the grass is dying.
Okay.
The water just pools in those areas that I was showing you on the map. And that's probably happened in the last year, just given the rain we've had.
Right.
And it's part of the state. But the guy told me, and again, he's not an expert on drainage, of course. He's an expert on grass, I guess. But he told
right.
me that I was not even trying anything until I got rid of the water issues.
Okay. Yeah. So go ahead and you know how to flip your phone around to show the other camera?
Yeah, I think you had it.
You just had it. Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
There we go.
So go ahead and just go out. Is the problem right there in front of us also?
Yeah. So let me get you oriented to the front of the house.
Okay.
So this here is the front of the house. That's the driveway. So this area here. So what's happening here? Is I've got this grade slopes down here.
Right.
And then I've got that up there that slopes down here. So this water just pours in here.
Okay.
And what it does, it just sets right all up in that area there.
Okay.
And it doesn't go anywhere but here.
Okay.
Now this drain downspout over here, I've got with the flex duct connected, which comes out around this side, and then down the driveway.
Right.
Same thing over here. I just recently did this because you can see where the water was actually. The dump was facing this way.
Right.
The water was just running out that. So I put this there and that. When it downpoured the other day, that seemed to work pretty well. It funneled down the grade of the driveway out to the street.
Okay.
So I think those two, right, wrong, or different, I think I solved those maybe by doing a little rigging. But I do still have these areas here too, in front of the beds. You can see a little bit of the grass dying.
Okay.
It hasn't come in with the rest of the lawn. This water drains really well, and the soil there tends to be a little more sandy.
Okay.
And in the back of the yard, you find more of a clay type soil.
Okay. Okay.
At least from what I noticed, the limited digging that I've done around the house.
Okay.
So this area here, all the way back on the side, down this middle portion here, you get runoff from our house and this house here, and it pools all in the middle there.
Right.
And then, of course, there's a downspout here
right.
that has nowhere to go but the yard, which contributes to that.
Okay.
So that's that piece.
Okay. Right there for a second. Does your neighbor have gutters?
They do not.
Okay. And it didn't look like they did, so there's a lot of water coming all over the place. Okay.
Yeah, so all the way back here, this area stays, after it rains, it stays pretty damp.
Okay.
And the water doesn't pool so much in here unless it rains really heavy, but it gets really slushy.
Right.
All the way up to that area that we started at.
Okay.
It starts pooling back here in the back.
Right, I see it.
Yeah, right here in the fence line, all the way around. And then here you get a nice fat puddle all in this area here. And this actually, this water here stays standing for about the same time the water in the front porch area starts, you know, stays standing. So it's quite a while after it rains.
Right.
Quite a few hours. I'm gonna take care of this fence here a little bit.
Okay.
And of course, there's a downspout right there. You can see that.
Yep.
And then that water, you know, kind of rolls into that, kind of helps feed that area. And then all this down here.
Okay.
You know, pools with water as well.
Okay. But they're all saying the same thing I'm telling you. A third of a horsepower would probably keep up with that water during average rainfalls. You know, in December when we had all that big rain, and since you're on the coast, you get even different rains than we do here in Charlotte. And they're severe. You get really big storms, or the hurricane might just brush up along you. You know, I know there's a lot more. It'll never keep up with the hurricane. that's impossible. But you're giving it a place to go, you know, so that it won't stand there for days and days or hours and hours. Right now, it has no place to go at all. So a third of a horsepower pumps between 40 and 60 gallons a minute. And you can do this research as you start looking into to pumps. But a third of a horse pumps, you know, 40 to 60 gallons a minute. And that's that's with a 5 foot rise, a 5 foot head, okay? Bringing it up 5 feet. Half horsepowers pump between 60 and 80 gallons a minute. Same thing, 5 foot head. A 1 horsepower pump will pump 120 gallons a minute, which is a lot of water. I mean, that's a tremendous amount of water. If you think about a trash can, that's 3 trash cans full of water every minute. That's how fast it pumps.
Just a couple questions. So the catch basin, I've seen some of those at Lowe's and whatnot, but can you accomplish the same thing with, like, I guess, can you put that section of pipe, make it into a French drain?
You can, but think about how a French drain works. French drain is perforated pipe surrounded by gravel. That's what a French drain is. And what it does is it picks up subsurface water. So anything that's moving underground, you know, actually it's water that rises up, you know, groundwater rises, that's what picks up in the French drain. The catch basin picks up immediate surface water runoff. So ideally is to put both in.
So as far as one more question I had, so I've obviously done some research and I've obviously looked at a few things, and I frequent Lowe's quite a bit, and like any guy does, right?
Yeah.
So you go in and you dream a little bit, and so I walked around the drainage area, and that's where I saw the easy drains and, you know, all the other paraphernalia, I guess, for lack of a better term.
Right.
One thing I noticed was those pop-ups you were talking about. If for whatever reason the HOA or we're actually right on the city limits, so the utilities and water and I guess the storm drains would all be city. If for whatever reason they have issue with me cutting that curb, will those pop-ups be an option? And I guess do they work?
Okay, the pop-ups is a fine option if you have good gravity. In other words, if you think about like my cup, for example, if you looked at the pop-ups, this is a 90-degree turn. So you lost almost 5 inches of fall because the water has to come back up.
If you were a new burn and you came to this job and quoted it out, what would you quote it out for?
Okay, again, if it's gravity, let's start with gravity, okay? And assume that we're going out to the front. It looks like you're going to have approximately 300 to 350 feet of pipe to send everything out to the front. So we'll call it 400 feet. I usually do that to be safe on a quote. You're looking at anywhere between 2,800 and 3,800. And that's why I'm an advocate of do it yourself. Because if you I know you want to get it all done at once, and maybe money's not a real big issue, and I think it is to everybody, but
You know, do one side of the house first, all by yourself. You know, just do one side. And then, you know, yeah, you'll be tired, you'll be wore out. Even if you bring your friends over, you know, it doesn't matter. You'll be exhausted, I promise you, because it's not what you do. You know, I mean, it's like we do it every day, and we'll get that job done in a day and a half. We're quick. But just, you know, do one side. Maybe even do the front, looking at the house, do the front right-hand corner, that downspout, and the one that's not inside the walk, you know, so that you tie that one to it. Just do that much of it, but make sure it's deep enough that you can connect the back to it. And again, any questions or anything, just call Steve.
All right, thanks, Jeff. And you'll send me an invoice on PayPal.
Yeah, that'll be. I probably won't get that done here tonight either.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah.
All right, I appreciate it.
Yeah. When you get the drawing, you know, if you have any questions or anything, just let me know.
All right. Thanks, Jeff.
Have a great weekend.
You too.
Mm-hmm. Bye.
Hey, this is Chuck with Apple Drains reminding you that if you believe you can do something, I guarantee you can do it. If you're interested in the video conference, come to our website, sign up online. We'll give you help with project planning, drawings, how-to help, and more.